This is Support a Sexy, episode 413. Today, we're continuing our series on money moves, and we're talking about building your team. Welcome to Support a Sexy. I'm your host, Elayne Fluker, entrepreneur, author, and founder of Chic Rebellion Media. 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, I bring you inspiring women entrepreneurs who share their wins and lessons to help you take your business to the next level. Here we go. Hi, everyone. Welcome to a new episode of Support is Sexy. I'm so happy to have you here for part four of our Money Move series. You know why? It just would not be the same without you. And today, as I talked about, we're going to talk about building your team. And you know what you need to have first before you even think about building your team? Vision. That's why if you're in Atlanta on Monday, February 19th, and if it's a holiday for you, maybe you have off from work, if you are working a full-time job, if you're an entrepreneur, I hope you can make it, because we are getting together to create your vision board. Monday, February 19th in Atlanta at supportissexyvision.com to find out more, to find out the location. I'm still learning my way around Atlanta, but I am going to be there with you to not only create your vision board, but to also talk about what is your vision, what do you really want, and what are the things that are standing in your way? How can we clear those blocks? So we're going to do some work and we're going to have some fun, actually lots of fun. I've been doing vision boards for years. I love it. I love the process. So come out, join me Monday, February 19th, starting in the morning, 10 a.m. We're going to have a little breakfast and then we're going to work it out all day. Supportissexyvision.com. Now, as an entrepreneur, you know you have to get to the point where you build your team. Or maybe you don't know that. Actually, I will say I didn't know that. This whole Support is Sexy thing started for me because I didn't know how to accept support. So really building a team is something that you grow into as a business, but also have to grow into mentally, just realizing that you need some help. You need a little bit of support. So we're going to talk about that today. Those people who are going to help you grow your business and support you as you grow your business. So supporting you personally, supporting you in your business, and supporting your business itself as it grows. Now, building a team is a high priority for me this year for Support is Sexy and for the new part of my business, girlonpodcast.com, which is a podcast booking service for women focused on women who guest and women who podcast, connecting the two so they can rock both sides of the mic and get their messages out into the world. You know, it's what I'm passionate about. But you know what I need to support that passion? A team. And like I said, now I get this, but when I first started my business, it took me a minute. So I understand if you don't get it yet, or if this is the first time you're really thinking about it. Maybe you, of course, have heard about it. Maybe you thought, though, that it didn't apply to you. Maybe it may be even years before you even think about really seriously building your team because you're in so deep, especially in the beginning. You're doing everything yourself. You may not have the revenue just yet to hire even a freelancer, much less a team. Although I've always worked with great freelancers over the years on different projects, I will say this is my first time really enrolling people in my business, thinking about specific parts of my team, of my business, where I'm going to bring in people. Now is the time. So for you, I'm going to go through some things for you to consider about why you should build a team and how you could build a team and what that team could look like. It doesn't necessarily have to be what the first thing that comes to mind is, this huge company, this huge team. You might grow into that if that's really what you want to do. But to start out, don't get intimidated by this idea because really, you know, it's all about support. It all goes back to support around here because support is sexy. So for you, some ways to realize that it may be time to bring in your team. Here are some ideas. You've maxed out with what you're able to do alone. Have you been there? You get to the point where your business is outgrowing you. You can't keep up the pace. Your juggling routine has just turned into a hot mess and you need help. You have to get to the point where you stop and say, okay, I need help. Maybe you don't have your head down and you're all into what you're doing. You have your head up and you still can't keep up. That's a good time to bring in someone or someone's to help you. Another reason is you have revenue that will cover the expense of part-time support. Now, I know, again, when you're first starting out, if you're in the early stages and maybe your business has just started to make some money, even if it's a little bit of money, a little bit, it's all relative, right? But maybe it's in the early days, let's say, let's not say a little bit. We're not even going to put that language out there. Say it's in the early stages, so you've just started making money, but things are growing fast, and again, you're trying to juggle and keep up. It is still time to consider bringing in someone, and it could be a part-time person. And if you have the revenue to cover that part-time person, definitely consider it. Now, this is important when I say consider if you have the revenue, because you don't want to stress yourself out by adding someone. This is supposed to relieve stress, right? So really do your numbers, look at what your expenses are, see if this is something that's possible right now. Even if it's not, you know, we have possibility mindsets around here. So put it in mind that this is a vision, something that you want to do very soon. But make sure you're clear on how much this will cost you each month. And if you are enrolling freelancers or contractors, be clear that you both agree on the amount each month so you can plan ahead. The next reason you might think about bringing in a team, you're ready to grow your business. Now, truthfully for me, the idea of bringing on a team, whether it's individuals, an agency, whoever, is both exciting and scary for me. I have to admit it. Outside of the expense, which of course we all think about, as I just said, it's a signal to me that my business is growing. I'm like, don't tell anybody it's growing, but it's a great thing. And in order for it to continue to grow, though, I am clear that I have to invest and believe that it's worth it. That's the thing, right? It's all a mindset game, basically. You've heard a lot of people talk about imposter syndrome because it's real. That's why a lot of people talk about it. So it's all a mindset game, which I work to strengthen every day, to be honest. So if you're having any fears around this, do the work, get some support, get a coach, whatever you have to do to expand your mind so you can expand your business. So many entrepreneurs who make it into the $1 million a year kind of business talk about how much went into mindset, even to get to 6 figures a year just from your business, not any other projects, not any other full-time job, anything like that. Growing your business to a 6-figure-a-year business, at least, everyone says it takes mindset. All the successful entrepreneurs I know, even if not personally and follow, talk about mindset. So do the work, get the support, get a coach, whatever you need so you can expand your business if that's one of your goals and expand your team, which will help you expand your business. And I will say, you know, now I go into things with this kind of mindset. Anytime I start a new project or business, that's what I start off thinking about. I think, how am I going to get support for this? And that is a huge mindset shift for me. I'm telling you, the support is sexy work, and working with coaches and all these other people have really shifted everything. Before, I would think, how can I make this happen? You know, I'm trying to get away from that language, right? How can I make this happen? How can I do this? What do I need to do? No, I start with, how can I get support for this thing? And that is what I think of first. Now, here are some things to remember, though, when you're thinking about building your team. This doesn't have to be your forever team. I mean, or maybe it is, but it doesn't have to be. For now is not forever, as my friend Erica says. This is about what's most supportive to you now. Who you need now might not be who you need 10 months from now, might not be who you need 2 years from now. You're going to grow at a different pace. Other people are going to grow at a different pace. So don't get caught up in, well, I want to make sure I hire the right person forever. You want them to be the best person now to support you. Like everything else, this is going to evolve. Also, remember, take baby steps. When I talk about a team, I'm not talking about go out and hire 20 people if you're still up in your bedroom running your business, which nothing's wrong with that. I'm saying, though, let's keep it all in perspective. You can test, though, what a part-time support person might be for you. Maybe it's a VA, a virtual assistant. Maybe it's even an intern to start out with. I love getting paid help just because people have some kind of accountability. But even if it's an intern can do it for credit if possible. That's the thing I love about interns who get credit for school if they work with you. So see if that's a possibility. But what I'm saying is, take baby steps. You're not jumping into hiring a full team and being responsible for people's livelihood. Baby steps, even if you start with an intern. Now, that perfectly segues into teams can come in all different sizes. As I mentioned, interns, get an intern who can do it for credit if possible. A lot of schools are open to that. You don't have to be this huge company. Maybe it's interns who are in entrepreneurship programs. A lot of colleges have that now. So if you have a business, you're officially doing business, is there a way for you to find an intern who can get it for some kind of credit towards a course, any kind of credit, however they work it out in schools now? But see if you can get an intern. You also, of course, can get freelancers. So you hire someone for a certain project, a certain amount of time. Great resources and easy ways to find good people are Fiverr, which I'll have a link to. Upwork is another site. I know there are plenty others out there, but those are two that I have actually used to find the right people. In fact, a gentleman, James, that I work with, that I met on Fiverr and have worked with, I don't know how many years it's been now, but he's a video editor. He does incredible work. We've been working together ever since. So you can find really great people on there. Then, of course, your team could also look like paid staff. You know how that works. You have a salaried person. You pay them an annual or whatever kind of salary or hourly wage that you're going to pay them. But, of course, that could look like your team as well. Also, people that I love to use are contractors, which to me is a little bit different than freelancers. To some people, it's exactly the same. Freelancers, I feel like a short period, work on certain projects, and then you're usually done. A contractor you can have for however long. More often, they're paid a flat fee per month for certain services rather than hourly, which, again, this is something I prefer. I know the amount that I have to pay each month, and I know the deliverable. I don't get caught up in hours, as I talked about in the previous episode. For myself, I don't do that. And for other people, I rather say, this is what I need delivered every month. If it takes them 15 minutes, I don't care. I want this every month, and this is what I'm going to pay. So that's a good thing about most contractors. Another person who could be on your team is a virtual assistant. A lot of us, the schedule is the main thing, right? I know I'm trying to keep control of my schedule right now, but I'm eventually going to have to let that go. But your schedule and a lot of other things that we have to do are the main thing. Keeping up with things, making sure, again, that we're juggling efficiently, if that's even possible. So think about a virtual assistant. Maybe it's a part-time person. Again, if you're launching or doing something big at the time, you're working on a project, you're going on a tour, you're doing whatever. Maybe you bring an assistant in for a short time per project or pay them for their expertise on a particular project. So they might come in and assist you with, again, launching or doing a certain thing, and then you might not need them until the next project. But a virtual assistant is also a great way to get support, and you can do that part-time or hourly and say how much time you want. That's the thing to remember too. You have control. You don't want to get yourself tied into anything again where you're doing too much or taking on too much. So baby steps, you have control. Test it out. You're testing the waters on this, but I want you to think in the framework of building a team, because it's all about support, which is actually another big part of your team. Making sure that you, as an entrepreneur, as a leader, have support, not just from your team that we mentioned, but support being a mentor or a coach or someone else who advises you personally as a person, but also as a leader, because you need someone to look to for advice, for mentorship, any kind of issues that you have, any kind of questions that you have. The best leaders have coaches, mentors, and other people to advise them on how to be better and how to keep themselves sane and focused and all the things that we need to be as leaders. So make sure when you're thinking about your team, it's not just these support people, it's also people you can look to for advice and betterment of yourself. So again, these are just a few ideas on how to build your team. Even if you're in the early stages, start thinking about what that team could look like. What, as we said in the beginning, is your vision? You are limited by the limitations of your team. Something else I've learned, especially if you don't have one. So eventually you want to grow into this, because your business can only grow when it's more than you, when it's not just you. You can only scale so much. You are one person. You're a fantastic and superwoman, but you're not superwoman, right? So you need to get some support. When it's just you, you've basically created a job for yourself, not a business. And if you can't replace yourself, that means you're not focusing on the bigger picture. You're a worker, not a boss. And I want you to be a boss. So get you a team. All right. So now tomorrow, in our final part of the series, we're going to talk about how to share the message of your business and in what ways make the best use of your money. So thank you so much for being here. You know, I appreciate you. Again, if you're in Atlanta on Monday, February 19th, come on out and join me for the Support is Sexy Vision Board Party. Go to supportisexyvision.com to find out more. I hope to see you there. If not, I'll check back in with you here on the podcast. Until then, though, always remember, you deserve support. And I'll talk to you soon. Take care.